Good morning. It's Winsome Gunning. I'm standing in my garden, about to do some autumn pruning and cutting away and preparing the soil for the winter crops. But I do love the summer garden. I love the abundance, the overgrownness. I'm just focusing in here on passion fruit growing on the vine. It's just a lovely feeling, all this abundance. But with March, although it's going to be very hot today, that's why I'm starting early. It's supposed to be 34 degrees, so I'm getting in before it gets too hot. Oh. We need a different type of soil. I've introduced you before to the tree lettuce. I've let this grow, go to seed, because this will plant itself around the garden. I can weed out the ones I don't want. But that was a food that early in summer I just had a craving to eat all the time. Over here is the area that I'm going to prune and start sorting out. So I'll show you that as I do it. Well, here we are underway. I'm still digging. Just discovered these lovely little worms. I love it when there's lots of worms. I'll cover them up with some soil. Poor little things. I've got a shock, I think. There we are. It's good to find the worms in the soil. It shows that it's being worked. It's all alive. Now, am I brave enough to harvest the yarcon today? It's amazingly tall, but it's taking probably a lot of goodness from the soil and shade. So this is the yarcon. Now I'm going to cut it back and start digging. That's the Peruvian ground apple. Okay, that's the next step. Okay, underway. I've dug, cut off a couple of the tall leaves of the Peruvian ground apple, and here they are in my hand. I've taken the leaves off, and I'll keep these for replanting. That's how you replant them. So I want to keep those. I also have kept some of these ground cover sweet potatoes. These are the ones that sometimes, if you're lucky, have nice little orange sweet potatoes, and also the leaves are good in salads, but I've just kept some of those for replanting. So now I'll go down and cut some more down, and then I'll dig into the ground and see what we have there. So here we have all the stalks of the Peruvian ground apple. I'm saving those because they can be replanted. It also gets some of the little tubers to replant. Now over here in the ground that I'm clearing, we now have just the stalks of the yarcon, the Peruvian ground apple. I'm about to dig in and see what we have underneath the soil. Sometimes when you have that amount of growth, you don't have a lot of actually fruit, because these are ground apples, in the ground, because all the growth has gone into the leaves, etc. Over here I have some other ones which I'll be digging later, and those ones may have more fruit than this really large plant. All the leaves I have placed over here, that's called chop and drop, so they'll add to the nutrients for the crops. So when I harvest that area, or clear that area, then I will, when that area is cleared, we'll dig those in. They'll be broken down by then. And here we have the cassava, which will be later. I'll do a chopping and dropping of that, and of course I save the stalks of that as well for regrowth. So now we'll dig into this and we'll see what we come up with. And here are the yarcons. Not a great crop. You can see here how they form on the roots. I have harvested them too quickly, but I needed that ground, and the leaves were taking away the sun from the next lot of plants for the amount of goodness I was going to get. All of those, if I'd left them, would have got fat, but I can't give them that much soil at the moment. I need that soil for the next lot of crops. I'll wash these up and show you what they look like when I've, but it's going to be a very small harvest off that great big plant. Yeah, not disappointed. Just know I have to do more work on my soil. This is full of seaweed emulsion. I'm going to put that on these little eggplants here that somehow have made it through the summer, but they haven't really grown because the yarcons were taking their sun and their nutrients. Soil, I'll dig again. It's just starting to work the soil for the winter crops, and with vegetables so expensive in the shops at present, I need to use this land, which is one of my best areas in terms of sunlight in the winter. I need to get that really enriched with some compost and a good digging over. I've got lots of roots from all the trees around, so that doesn't help. Last year I got a lot of good out of these pots, so anyway, I need to think all that through, but at least I've started. I've been procrastinating for so long, and even today it's going to be 34 degrees, so I'm heading inside pretty soon. Cassava next. I hope we get some more crop out of that, but no more likelihood really, because it's my soil. I have built the soil up from scratch. I've put every bit of food waste, etc., has gone into the soil. Mulch, etc., etc., but it takes a continual working to keep soil good. One good thing is it had there's lots of worms in there, so that shows a healthy soil. I remember when I was at the community garden, we started there, we used to go and if we saw a worm and anywhere, we'd take it down and pop it in our gardens. But these trees will be taking a lot from the soil as well, so I'll have to look at pruning, cutting, more chopping and dropping. But anyway, just a little walk around before I go upstairs and wash those yarcons, and then I'll show them to you again. Let's see, what is the wonderful moringa, the miracle tree. I'm eating from that every day at the moment. One a frond, at least. I'll take upstairs and put those leaves on my salad or steamed vegetables at night. So I've just got to get my soil richer, which is continual work. I may get a bit more luck in these sweet potatoes, but because it's been so hot and sweet potatoes seem form fruit in cold weather, I don't think so. They seem to run a lot. So you've got a lot of shoots you can put in salads, etc., in hot weather, but you don't really have much fruit. Anyway, upstairs now, I'll wash those yarcons and clean them up and show you what I've got, but I think it's very scant takings. Still haven't got upstairs. I've just done a little bit more weeding. I've dug over the soil again just to get rid of roots that seem to have got into it, and then I've cut down banana leaves that were going yellow. The rain leaches a lot out of the soil, so I will need to put some more into my soil. I'll need to do some research on that. Anyway, here are the banana leaves, all forming the pathway. Everything is recycled back here. That's what it's all about. Trying to be sustainable, trying to create foods that will grow in this climate. Yes, I'm just now going to wash the yarcon. They were disappointing, but I had a feeling I'd harvested them too quickly, but at least now I can work on the soil. It's into March already, but it's so hot. As I said, at least 34, they've said today, which means hotter up here on the hills. So we're trying to get a garden growing and produce food. Anyway, off to wash the Yukon and I'll see what I can get to show you. Well, that's not a great crop, is it? I'm going to peel that little fat one and show you what it looks like inside. And the other skinny roots that I left on the stalk are downstairs in a bucket of water. I'm going to replant them. I have harvested too quickly. I don't know how. I won't put them in that part of the garden. I'll put them further down where they're not going to shade things. They were just shading my winter crop area too much, and I don't think it was going anywhere. Very disappointed. I have grown these before and got a much bigger crop. But anyway, I'll just peel them. I can't peel them and take the photo, so I'll show you what they look like peeled. Hi, and this is it. I definitely cut them down too quickly, and as I have already said, I'm going to replant those roots with the lots of the little ones about to fatten up. But anyway, here I am about to eat my first Peruvian ground apple from my newly made soil. Well, it was worth it. It's amazing. It's really sweet and crunchy and just wonderful. So I just wish I had more. But every time we learn something new, we really do. Sorry to eat with my talk with my mouth full. My mother taught me never to do that, but it is delicious. And to prove it, I'm going to have another bite. Oh, that was worth it. Full of nutrient-rich minerals, apparently, but also really sweet and yummy. And I will put those, definitely put the other ones back in the ground, and hopefully the root with the tubers on that didn't fatten up because I picked it too soon. We might get some more later. Oh, that is nice. Sorry, I can't speak. Well, bye for now, and I'll do better next time. Hope you subscribe. I've got the cassava to harvest yet. I don't know what I'm going to achieve there, but then I'll be planting the crops for winter. Trying to do my bit with my food forest, but really it's a learning curve. Thank you for watching. Bye.